Hello, hello, hello.
We are Violent Vira, an alternative rock band from Dallas, Texas, and this is I Don't Care.
That was I Don't Care by Violent Vira. Blank, their bassist, Matt and Anthony, their guitarist, Andrew, their drummer, and Vira joined us in collaboration with Denton Community Television to promote a special interview and performance for their Lover of a Ghost tour. Due to equipment malfunction, the interview audio information was damaged. Paige Doyle, our indie music director, follows with the interview.
All right, I'm here with the band Violent Vira, and we are here at Quincy Night One Indie Alt Rock Social. We just watched an amazing performance from these people, and we're really excited to hear more about their music. Can you guys please explain your band and also give a short introduction going around?
For sure. So we're an alternative rock band based out of Dallas, Texas, and we just established ourselves about 2 months ago. We've been playing for almost a year now. But we're officially a band, and this is Blake as our bassist.
This is Manon,
but I could say this that Anthony, as well as the guitarist, and Ria is hopping on with us on this tour as our drummer.
Also, Manon, I'm very big to you.
You like done that?
So you are Vira.
Yeah.
All right. Who is writing your guys' songs? Is it a collaborative process, or is it just one person?
Previously, for our EP that we put out last year, I produced all those songs myself. Before, we met, she had put out a couple of singles by herself, but then, we met first before these guys, and I worked on a couple of songs with her by myself, and then we met those guys before, like, our last tour, and we toured with them, and now, like, for future projects, we're going to be writing all together as the band.
Uh-huh.
A little too quietly. No. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm listening in. I listen. But I'm projecting more at, like, it's meant for recording, so people are lingering before their voices. I really have, like, basically shouting into it. Chill into it.
What is this bringing? What about the vehicles?
So we can, yeah, I did recommend that. We'll clip it and it'll be fine.
So originally, like, I produced a couple of songs. Like, I did our EP together and a couple of other singles. And then we met these two guys here. And now, like, for future projects, we're all going to be writing together as a band.
Yes, that's true.
Yeah. Awesome. I'm excited to hear what you guys have. Your last EP was a year ago, correct? Do you guys have any plans to release new music soon?
It's the album right now that we're planning to release. So it's going to be around like 12 to 13 tracks. We haven't put out any singles because we really want to focus our energy on this specific project. It's a little different writing within our band and writing everything from scratch. So yeah, it's almost done. It's almost done, but I don't have a specific date for when it's going to be released yet.
Never one night.
Right, which for sure.
You get a feel for it. I'm going to play live.
Okay, awesome. So you guys are planning on playing some unreleased songs on tour?
Yeah, just.
Okay, awesome.
It gauge, like, I think the reaction of people, it really helps. And that's why we're doing that thing, you know?
Yeah, it's interesting. Yeah, no, that totally makes sense. What are the guys' bands and musical influences that you guys aspire to?
Should we start from this side? Yeah.
Sure. So my favorite bands right now are Tidal Fight. They're like a punk band from Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
I really like From First to Last right now. And I mean, I guess like one for all of us would be like My Chemical Romance.
Yes, I'm hugely inspired by My Chem. And I have a lot of like pop burner influences that I really look up to, and I feel like bleeding into my music, hard music now, sorry. Yeah, with Marina, and then Lana, yeah.
Yeah, even more as a stand, as well as, like, you know, I just started on My Chemical Romance and, like, Pierce the Mill, and the Weft Towns, says so bad. I would say my influences range, but my favorite bands as of right now are probably like Incubus, Radiohead. I love like Fine Roasts, like My Chem, and it's just anything really emo. It's really emo, but I really love them. Loving like 90s, just 90s radio rock. Wait, William.
Hi. Ooh, I forgot to mention Breaking Benjamin, Crazy Eye. Yeah.
Awesome. So you guys have been a band. How long have you guys been working together?
I think we met about like
two
years ago, like exactly this month, honestly.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, when we met, we like immediately started to like want to make music together because both of us were doing kind of like our own thing at first. And
is that when Violent Vira took off?
I really, but I think it was like starting to pick up, and he was a producer online at the time, so that's how we met. I think this was when God Complex was kind of having its little violent moment.
Right. I wanted to ask about the virality of Band Complex, and also I Don't Care as well. Both really hit TikTok, and I know that a bunch of your fans probably came from TikTok. How do you feel about this, like, new age of music where artists are using TikTok to discover, or to help fans discover, and vice versa?
Yeah, I know that saying TikTok artists gets a bad rep, but I think that it's really the new music app just like MySpace was back in the day. And I feel like there's always going to be a new version of it, and it's going to keep evolving. So it's been really good. I think that it's honestly a blessing because there was like YouTube at first, and then there was SoundCloud, and now it's TikTok's turn for music. There was, I don't think that I would have been able to be where I am today and form a band without it, honestly. So, yeah. Hey, TikTok, don't remove it, please, please. We don't know if we were saying, look at you, we were. All right, so how do you guys think you go in a space in the traditional rock genre, and how do you think that you are kind of stepping out of the bounds of traditional rock? I'm interested in what your guys' take is on your own music and where it stands.
No one has to talk about
something that there's
the bullets. I think something that is really good about like our previous music is that you could really call like each song a different subgenre if you wanted to, you know, like not like the songs that are out right now, you can't really like
no two songs really sound the same, honestly. And I think it's like the variety that is really good.
Also, I don't even think like genres really matter.
Yeah,
it's really just like the artist behind the music that matters, because like they like Michael Jackson or whatever, like we never stuck to one genre. Where everyone liked Michael Jackson.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, I think the biggest attachment in the music is Amy. Like, muting the words.
So when we cut that out. That's it. You're kind of over it.
Yeah, I'll turn that with them. But no, I think that the biggest part of the music is Vira and how, like, her words and her singing just connect with
me. Yeah, and be real.
Absolutely. That is... Thank you, Tony. One thing that I've noticed across the board is every single band of yours deeply loves your music. Like, it's really cool to see you have such passionate fans. And even as someone who is coming in to this, like, I knew you were 2 months ago, but I hadn't really done a deep dive. And, like, your songs make people feel things, and that's the important part.
Thank you.
Yeah, of course. So, what is your favorite part about making music? You guys can take turns on this one, too.
Hello. It's like the best job in the world. we have to, like, hang out and try to create something that will continue to make people feel the way all these songs have been making people grasp onto, you know? It's awesome.
Yeah.
I don't know any other way to explain it. It's honestly, like, kind of messed up. My dopamine receptors, because I don't trap to the outfit that I could actually do anything else for money. That's like, hey, I was muted at some wise. She said, I would have started psycho stuff.
Yeah. I feel like music has honestly really saved my life and has had me through the worst times of my life as well. So to be able to do that for other people is definitely the most rewarding part. Like when fans come up to me and tell me that my music has helped them push through some of the struggles in their life. It means everything, like absolutely everything to me. So lots of dopamine.
I don't
really know if I can add anything else. Like, I feel that all three of them said, I love touring too.
As like summer camp. No, yeah.
Yeah, not yet. A little bit the upcoming tour.
And it's silly excited, but also so nervous because it's like, going to be so long. So he's 1 year over then.
Yeah, when what you did, it does not feel like it's 20 days. I felt 17, actually.
That's awesome. I saw that you guys are kind of hitting, like, a lot of spots. Have you guys done a tour of this size before? Is it your first time?
We did a West Coast tour, and we had the Midwest a little bit in Texas, but this is our first time in the East Coast, as well as, like, I like going everywhere. Yeah, everywhere. Yeah, we're going pretty much everywhere.
That's what it looks like.
Yeah, as a band, this is our second tour ever. And our second time headlining as well. So we're really excited. It was a really good turnout last time.
I'm stuttering so much. I'm sorry.
You're good.
And it's going to be even better this time. I hope so.
It will be.
Yeah.
I'm excited. All right. And then, so are you guys currently in the process of being signed to a label? Do you guys want that? Do you guys not want that? What's your take on having a backing like that?
It just depends on whatever labels we talk to and what they offer.
Mm-hmm.
If it meant going independent for the debut album, if that was the best option, if the labels that we've talked to and their offers and what they can provide, I think it would be worth it to go with the label, just depending on it, you know, how the conditions of it.
All right.
We've been like completely independent up until this point. Like, we literally just signed with a manager.
Okay.
A couple weeks ago.
Oh.
Yeah, we've just been like going over the options with them lately.
Awesome.
Like what to do with the upcoming like record or future projects and stuff like that.
That's clear. Yeah, our managers, we have two of them, and they've been talking to a lot of labels right now on behalf of us, so
I'm trying to find the best options for what we want to do.
Yeah, is that things I was involved, but like money, growth, like what they say they'll do for us, like what we think will happen. There's so many like variables that,
of course,
as it
stands right now, there's no final decision. Yeah,
I've talked to some like industry people, and they were just like, "You would do fine independently." But you never know, like, in the way you might be getting out of, like, an opportunity like that, like, you could just, like, jump you, or you never know what you're going to miss out on.
Yeah.
I think the thing that would be the most helpful is just to have someone, handle some stuff for us, because as we get bigger, it's also getting a lot harder to manage things, so.
Yeah, more things to do.
Yeah.
All right, what's the message you guys hope to convey through the music you guys make?
The message of our music is to be angry, violence, but like in the best way possible. No, that's corny. No, that's not. I really just think that it's really like angry in the best way possible. Like, it's cathartic and it makes people feel things and helps them through situations in their life and makes them want to cry, scream, big things, but it's all part of the process of healing, I think.
It's melancholic, and I also feel like it's like a window into your life a little bit, like the things you write about.
I just really want to write music. Like you said, like makes people feel things and people can attach on to and hopefully relate to, and yeah, just stuff like that. But
my fun.
It's
hard to say what an overall message is, because I think that every song is its own story. So I think it's up to the listener to decide that.
Absolutely. It's up to both.
Great.
I think that is the most big question. Oh, what has been your favorite concert outfit so far?
I like this question. Thank you. Like, last year, I think there was definitely like the Dallas, Texas one, because that was like a little emo.
You know, I actually saw that one, and that was my favorite personally.
Thank you. You should do it again in Dallas this year. For dancing, for the last one.
Last one's the trees. Yeah, the first one's the rubber beans.
Yeah.
How did the first one?
Oh, really? Kicking it. Yeah. Bang. Yeah. Well, and they, okay, we'll see. I do miss that outfit. It's really fun.
I don't want to over your stylist in the decision-making process.
It'd be like, right?
It was enough so much. They don't do it with but
we'll definitely watch and we'll shout out to you.
Awesome. That about wraps it up. Thank you so much, guys, for all participating. I hope that you guys have the best future in the music. industry, I guess, and do a bunch of really cool things. I'm excited to see you guys this tour. I'll be at the Rubber Gloves one.
Thanks to Paige Doyle for conducting the interview, and apologies to Violent Vira for the audio quality. The production team was myself, Ethan Leach, Gabriel Rector, Nicholas Dembla, and Anthony Santapietro. Thanks to Gabriel Rector and Aiden Cordina for their graphic design and animation contributions. Thanks to Macy Whiten, who also did the intro voiceover, and to Yanelli Padrone, who operated cameras during the performance. Special thanks to Dean Marshall and his team at DCTV for directing and facilitating this performance. Next up is You're Not Gone, You're Just Dead by Violent Vira.
Hi, we're Violent Vira, an alternative rock band from Dallas, Texas, and this is You're Not Gone, You're Just Dead.